Good day, madame.
Good day, monsieur.
Hey, good day,
there's a pupil for you. He's superb this morning, superb.
That's the motor playing in Sonata number 16. Frederick Chopin. To Weber. Oops. So it's been raining.
There's a pupil for you. He's superb this morning, superb.
And how's madame?
The same, thank you.
And how is little Isabel this fine day?
Very well, thank you, but it isn't a fine day. It's raining.
And what are you doing in the straw hat and slippers?
But only yesterday the sun was shining. Who can keep track of all these changes in the weather? From Paris this morning. Who sent it? Louis Pleyel. Who's he? Let me ask. Who owns the finest concert hall, the greatest publishing house in Paris? Monsieur Pleyel. Who was it when he was traveling through Germany 15 years ago, heard me play in a trio and shook my hand warmly and said, my dear friend, you were magnificent. I shall never forget you. Monsieur Pleyel. And now, who takes the time in faraway Paris to send an important letter to Professor Elsner, Warsaw, Poland?
Me.
Who?
Monsieur Pleyel.
Monsieur Pleyel. Yes. Listen. My dear Professor Elsner, thank you for your letter concerning the exceptional talent of your pupil, Frédéric Chopin. If the young pianist should ever find himself in Paris, we shall be pleased to give him a hearing. Respectfully, Henri Dupont, secretary to Louis Pleyel. Well, Frederick in Paris?
Naturally.
Chopin.
For the past year, I said to myself, Joseph, I said, this gifted boy must be shown to the world. The world is Paris. Paris is Pleyel, and Pleyel is your friend. Well, here's the answer.
Professor Friedrich's a little boy.
My dear madam, in Paris last month, a young pianist by the name of Franz Liszt made his debut, and he is 13 years old.
Friedrich is only 11.
Well,
what about the little question of money, Professor?
Money?
Well, this trip to Paris, yes.
For my teaching of French, we are scarcely alive as it is. Oh, yes, money.
In fact, when did we last pay you for a lesson, Professor?
I refuse to fill my head with trifles, madame, and that is final. I didn't say go to Paris tomorrow or next week, but I do say let us plan for it and save for it. There's a boy waiting to be heard, and here is Paris waiting to hear him. Someday those two facts must come together, madame. I insist upon it. Such tones from a piano. Mozart, as he should be played. Brilliance, the ease, the tip.
Isabel.
Frederick.
Frederick.
I don't remember that bit of Mozart.
More Polish prisoners.
Some waiter.
The Tsar is taking you to Siberia.
Perhaps so, Freddie. What about our lesson today? Come now.
You don't understand, Professor.
I don't understand. What?
You are not a Pole. You are German.
So? I cannot understand Siberia and freedom. My dear boy, music and freedom are like one. They both belong to the world. A real artist wants freedom in every country.
Do we see
Poland, too?
Well, listen to him. Of course, Poland.
Oh, video.
Please. You mean... you would even help?
Help? What do you mean, help?
Well, I've been talking to Jan and Titus. When we grow up, all the boys are going to help.
Then put down the name Joseph Elsner. He's with you.
Thank you.
Prescribing
Professor
your exam
Joseph.
Examinations. I mean, preparing for your examinations.
We have secret meetings. Will you come?
Submitting your work.
Pleasure, my boy.
But don't tell Father.
The examiners?
He'd worry.
I know. I know very well. All right, my boy, let's start. The Mozart, please.
Mozart? No, that's Frédéric Chopin.
Oh, it's Frédéric Chopin. He wrote it.
Say about his playing that he needs at least 3 more years of schooling and a change of teachers. That last dig, that was for my benefit. And the your Polonaise you played, you know what some idiot calls that? Barbaric.
Oh.
It's a long walk back to Warsaw, Professor. We'd better start.
Never. You think we come to Paris after 15 years and go home after one attempt? Never. I refused to walk back to Warsaw. In fact, I couldn't. My shoes need resoling. This one I won't even dignify with a reed. What's this? A genius such as this Frédéric Chopin appears only once in a hundred years. Has risen among us, brighter than we've ever seen. Your son. A man who's a woman. What's the difference? Let me half go. Here's a talking point.
Can we see it?
Here's a second concert in our pockets.
By messenger.
I don't have to sign.
No, monsieur.
Thank you, madame. What is it?
My dear Chopin, please, the Duchess of Orléans, you and your teacher, a tender reception at her home.
Thank you, Stephen.